The thing that the 60s did was show us the possibilities and the responsibility that we all had. It wasn't the answer, it just gave us a glimpse of the possibility. John Lennon. The 60s was an era of change and alteration of the American society in regards to race and gender. During this time period, the United States was most prominently known for the Vietnam War and protests that followed, the Civil Rights Movement, the Cuban Missile Crisis, and of course, its great music. The period follows a trend of people creating groups to advocate for what they believe in.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal.
Martin Luther King Jr. led hundreds of thousands of people to the March on Washington on August 28, 1963, where he gave his iconic speech, "I Have a Dream," inspiring his followers to aspire to obtain the rights and freedom that they deserve. The March on Washington was a peaceful demonstration by an estimated 250,000 people to promote economic equality and civil rights for African Americans. The goal of the protests included a comprehensive civil rights bill, protection of voting rights, and an overall end to discrimination in the country. This protest eventually led to the creation of the Civil Rights Act of 1964 and the Voting Rights Act of 1965. The efforts of the civil rights leaders and peaceful protesters eventually led to two legislations that became the turning point in the civil rights movement, the Civil Rights Act of 1964 and the Voting Rights Act of 1965. The Civil Rights Act banned discrimination in public places and employment based on race, gender, age, religion, sex, national origin, and later sexual orientation, and this enforced desegregation in schools. Initially, JFK proposed the bill to Congress, but after his assassination, LBJ and MLK Jr. continued to push for the passage of the bill. A year later, the Voting Rights Act was another bill signed by LBJ, which prohibited the use of literacy tests and poll tax, allowing African Americans to exercise their right to vote. During the 60s, Soviet influence was spreading all around the world, even to Cuba. The early 1960s involved various conflicts with Cuba, two of the most famous being Bay of Pigs and the Cuban Missile Crisis. The Bay of Pigs invasions was one of JFK administration's biggest embarrassments. This was a failed invasion led by the CIA against the communist leader of Cuba, Fidel Castro. The CIA planned to send Cuba exiles to start an anti-Castro uprising. However, the mission was poorly planned and funded, which led to its ultimate failure, increasing tensions between communist Cuba and the US. The Cuban Missile Crisis occurred over a period of 13 days, where the US and Soviet Union also created the first nuclear weapon war. Ultimately, this disastrous war was avoided when the Soviet leader agreed to remove the missiles in return for America, promising that they would not attack Cuba. Although during the Cold War, the Soviet Union and the US never participated in actual fighting, during the Cold War, they engaged in proxy wars throughout the world, one of them being in Vietnam. Throughout the war, many anti-war sentiments were spreading throughout the country, especially in college students. This gave rise to the hippie movement of the 60s. Hippies wore bright colors, ripped jeans, bell-bottoms, tie-dye clothing, and flowers. The hippies supported the anti-war and civil rights movements through promoting ideas of peace and love. Along with the Soviet Union and the US fighting proxy wars, during the 1950s and 1960s, they also took part in the space race. The race began in 1957, when the Soviets sent the first satellite to space. Throughout the years, the countries reached many different firsts, such as sending the first dog into space by the Soviets. Although it seemed as if the Soviets were winning the space race, in July of 1969, everything changed when NASA successfully sent the first astronauts to the moon.
One small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
In the 1960s, there was also a huge movement for feminism, the Women's Liberation Movement, in which women sought equal rights and personal freedom. This movement was initiated through protests of the Vietnam War and brought progress with the Equal Pay Act of 1963 and the Civil Rights Act of 1964. These women sought to change the way they were viewed, not only politically but socially, as an equal member of society that should be granted the same respect as any man. One prominent group was the Another Mother for Peace organization, a nonprofit group that opposed U.S. involvement in Vietnam, having a membership of over 225,000 people. This huge support allowed women to band together for what they believed in, using this softer approach of maternal feminism to lead into a more radical female stance to come. It was especially clever for the mothers to position their beliefs alongside public issues that others would agree with, and stand with the main tenet of their beliefs being the safety for their children. This is because during the 1960s, the idea of more rights for women had yet to be addressed. The 1960s were filled with societal and international changes. Major advancements were made during this time period in civil rights and women's rights movements. America established its position as an international superpower through events such as the Cuban Missile Crisis, the Vietnam War, and the arms race.